Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I want to thank the chairman and the ranking member for their consideration. I also want to thank the co-sponsors of this bill. Good bipartisan bill here. H.R. 3158 is also supported by virtually every farm group we can think of: American Farm Bureau Federation, National Council of Farmer Cooperatives, National Association of Wheat Growers, National Corn Growers Association, National Cotton Council, National Chicken Council, USA Rice Federation, American Soybean Association, National Cattlemen's Beef Association, the Turkey Federation, and National Milk Producers Federation. The spill prevention and containment program was first conceived in 1973. It's been revised, rewritten, extended, and delayed many times since then. Strict revisions were made to the SPCC regulations in July 2002 under the Bush administration. The rule has been changed a dozen times and compliance indefinitely suspended in 2006 for farms with less than 10,000 gallons in oil storage. Regulations of late on agriculture have been much stricter, and additional more restrictive changes were scheduled to go into effect in November of last year. These changes were delayed until May of 2013, due in large part to last year's natural disasters. The back-and-forth nature of the SPCC rule writing has brought unneeded confusion and great uncertainty to the farming community. The regulations slated to go into effect in May 2013 will require farmers and ranchers to build fuel containment berms to contain spills from above-ground oil storage facilities with a capacity of at least 1,320 gallons. Once you hit that 1,320-gallon threshold, you must comply with the SPCC regulations for every storage unit. Producers can self-certify compliance with the regulation if aggregate oil storage is between 1,300 and 10,000 gallons. Above 10,000 gallons would require the producer to procure the services of a professional engineer to verify certification. This regulation doesn't just apply to fuel, it applies to oil substances, even crop oil, vegetable oil, and animal fat. This bill would, or this regulation would hit nearly every farm in America and cost upwards of $60,000 in many cases to comply. So I urge support of this bill. It's a great opportunity, great bipartisan support, and support within the industry as we empower farmers to do more with less and relieve some of the regulatory burden that they face. With that, I yield back to the chairman.
Thank you.